What happened? We cleared it. With the powers combined, we were able to clear the life-threatening game. We've heard about clearing it. Why does the exit feel like it's not opening? It means it won't open. Air fighter. Not opening. Did I just tell you that? And just the exit. Every door we enter from is an opening. But the game isn't over yet. Any chance that the thing I found earlier was just joking around? Something in your hand, on your mind. Return to this room and receive the letter.
I'm sorry.
Thought it was just a prank, so I didn't have the chance to tell you. Even with enough of the excuses, hurry up and show it to me. What's this? Solve the mystery of the final dead room and you will obtain the right to participate in the life-threatening game. How the life-threatening game is a life-threatening reliable for hitting the roulette. Okay. Liable for setting the roulette's difficulty. Putting in the difficulty of prepared special prizes, but make sure you don't overdo yourself. What I meant? What does it mean? Even from now, was just the opening act. What is the real performance? I threw any roulette, that's probably like a Russian roulette. A gun came out of there. Means I had to use that to play Russian roulette, right? Russian roulette? Don't allow me. The cannon matter was too dangerous. I think I wanted to ask you. In all honesty, I didn't really understand the rules of Russian roulette. That's the case. Load one bullet into the cylinder and then spin it. After that point, the gun throws you and pull the trigger. Can't do that. There's like a 1/6 chance you'll die. Which means a failure rate is only 1/6. Is that really okay? Only a 1/6 chance of failing. Wouldn't the game be too easy? Shouldn't it be the opposite? Remove one bullet from the gun and then use it while there's still 5 bullets loaded. Do that, there will be a 1/6 chance of success. That would make it more of a thrilling game. What are you saying? Give it a go.
Hold on, Nagito. Hold on,
Nagito.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? Playing Russian roulette, obviously. I've only removed one bullet, so there's only a 1/6 chance that I'll survive. It's not much of a talent, but even I have an ultimate level talent, you know? I'm the ultimate lucky student. But if I can't win when there's only a 1/6 chance of success, then what kind of ultimate talent is that? I mean, if my luck gets me killed like this, there's no way you can really call that talent. If I'm truly the ultimate lucky student, I need to survive here. Isn't that right?
Please, stop!
And just now, that was the door unlocking, right? I didn't clear the final death room. Dead room, I'm scared of you, Nagito. Really? Let's go to the octagon, should just be on the door. Into the octagon, huh? What a disordered room.
Well done.
Congratulations, Nagito. He's here. Clearing the final death room. You can challenge yourself with the highest difficulty with only 1/6 chance of success. Mana's a present for someone like you. And other than the first, this is the future for Nature's file. You remember to get this when we were in the roller coaster? Can we have an extension of that?
Hey.
What are you giving? What are you giving without permission? Let's see, one more special prize. Here you go. This Hope Beats Academies. This file contains your student profiles from your time at the Hope Beats Academy. Profiles that you guys don't even remember. Our time at Hope Beats Academy, huh? After all this time, I can't believe it. No matter concerning your stolen school memories. I mean, a no good person like me actually spent time with everyone else at Hope Beats Academy. That's impossible. That's true. How did I feel? Surely I would have spent my time feeling ashamed of myself for being there in the presence of such greatness. Whether you're a bit or depressed, I still don't understand you at all. Anyway, I'm passing this along to you. How about I use it up to you? Take a long look at it later. Look at these profiles, I'll be able to find out what Hajime's talent is too. Be happy about it, yay, someone like me will finally be useful. Boo-hoo, am I open? What are you laughing about? Thought it was ironic, out of everyone here, someone like you was the only one who obtained Hope Peace Academy student profiles. Not sure if you're lucky or unlucky. What does that mean? Things are gonna get interesting. Yes, Nagito, you might be the one who makes things much more interesting. I don't really know what you're talking about. What are you planning on whispering in there? Anyway, Monami, no cheating, you haven't reached the end yet. Huh? You haven't rushed my light yet. Nagito already did it. No. Get over here, venture the final death room. Coercion. Jesus, are gone. In the end, I don't understand what Monokuma was talking about. I'll leave this file here, and first I need to find and investigate this room. I don't even know how to get out of here. The door. Access root hammers, metal wires, there are a lot of items near that could be used as weapons. Don't see anything that looks like it could be used as the ultimate weapon. I wonder what the so-called ultimate weapon is. A window? Why is there only one window in a place like this? Looks like there's some kind of hidden meaning to it. Actually, reality, what could it mean? In my mind, I entered the various possibilities as I walked slowly towards the window. Woman peeked out the window. Huh? This is what I actually saw outside was the window. A little different from any possibility I had in mind. That's what it was. So outside the window, sort of piecing together and thinking about it. Yeah, I see some of the finally starting to get a larger perspective of the funhouse. Where are we with this? A lot of weapons and firearms in here too. Handguns and grenade launchers even. Found the room is on the side of the door. Enter the room from this door. No need to bother going back. I need to throw a look around in here. I can turn.
Return to here. I was expecting to find the camp.
So there are poisons stored in here. You can secretly kill anyone with a poison weapon. In a way, you can be considered the most powerful weapon. You have to ignore the rules. Door on the floor? Isn't this the first floor of the strawberry house? It could be, lead to the underground, based on the sketch. There shouldn't have been a bunker. Maybe what lies behind this door. Things are finally getting interesting. Amazing. It's been the place that could not be reached unless you clear the final dead room. Thanks to how I arrived here. All the separate pieces seem to have connected together in one fell swoop. Chain reaction culminating in the truth, all thanks to just one clue. I know that now is not the time to enjoy things, but definitely a good feeling. Just through that window. That's where everything became pointed through from there. Just through that window, I realized the mystery of the ultimate weapon of the funhouse. All I have to do is tell everyone about this. Before I do that, I take a look at the file I received from Monokuma. I believe everyone's student's profile from the time I opened the academy, that's important. Cautiously opened the file and read it carefully, taking the care not to miss a single letter. Carefully. Huh? Hey? Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Huh? Sorry, did you say something?
Well?
I've been about 2 hours since we spoke to Furiko. I wonder if the elevator's been fixed yet. It'd be bad if we still split up before the class trial. Maybe we should call them one more time. You listening? I even brought that up because I'm really worried. Sorry, what are you gonna do? I'm worried about them too. Let's try to call Strawberry House one more time. That's a great idea, I think.
Hello there.
Hajime. Nagato, why are you here? Because I showed up. Shut up, how did you even come here? Maybe I teleported. Nagato's sudden appearance has been added to the true bull section of your handbook. Seriously, how did you be able to come to the side? Something I need to tell you guys, there is. I tried to investigate Strawberry House as much as I could. Give you those details first, let's hurry this up. Being abruptly interrupted by Nagato, Chiaki and I learned about the results of his investigation in Strawberry House. I guess those are pretty important. Actually, the fact that everyone in Strawberry House has heard the rumbling noise too. What about that wall clock alarm going off before that happened? Also, the fact that Strawberry Hall's button was broken and definitely not worth noting. Only thing I need to tell you guys, I'm through the funnel in dead room.
Could
Could be. Is this a life-threatening game? It wasn't threatening at all. The little escape room, then end up with some Russian roulette. Russian roulette? Even the one bullet, the gun's been the cylinder pointed towards you and pull the trigger.
Man.
You really did it? So that's how you're supposed to play it. What did they find out by only these one bullet? Yeah. This is just what Manomi said.
Actually.
Huh? I just turned the phone, he had to take one bullet out of the cylinder. That's how I did it. I only had a 1/6 chance of surviving. Still alive, after all. The only good thing about me is how lucky I am. What's wrong with him? I knew he was strange from the start, but for him, be passionate to be so suicidal. Crazy, that's all there is to it. Anyway, because I was able to clear the final dead room, I was able to obtain several rights. One of those rights was the freedom to move between Grape House and Strawberry House. Not only that, but whenever I move back and forth, I don't even need to play the game again. Back and forth, where would you even be able to do that but now?
You stay quiet.
Hey, Hajime, you've been repeating yourself over and over and it's bugging me. Can you let me speak freely for a change? Huh? Definitely lucky though, so that I was able to clear the roulette at the highest difficulty. I think what an amazing piece of process is my reward. That's the future information file? Yep, it's continuation of the file I received at the roller coaster. Continuation. Even more detailed information about the Killing School Life that was in the earlier file. Killing School Life? I mean the killings that took place at Hopix Academy, right? As I recall, Bayakiya was one of the students who participated in it. But even when we learn more about the Killing School Life, it has no relevance to us whatsoever. Information about the killing order of the killings and who the killer was for each incident. I find it extremely boring to read about the deaths of people that don't even know. That's Byakuya, of course. It's just a thought that Byakuya was the Byakuya we knew, right? However, I can't say that information was completely useless. In truth, there are similarities between the Killing School Life and the Killing School Trip. Similarities. Example, the first murder involves someone up important getting stabbed to death next to the place.
Hey.
Can murder reveal the presence of a serial killer among the group? Kinda. Heard murder was actually two killings that happened in succession?
Hey.
What do you guys think about these strange similarities? Well, definitely strange. I think of these as coincidences, maybe, especially if Monokuma is behind the motives driving the murders.
Hey.
What are you trying to say? I don't remember who died for the fourth. Fourth murder is a killing school was apparently a rule of suicide, right, Sakura? But come on. It was Gerbils? And it was fifth? It was a setup? That's right. Whether that means something or not, something each person should think about on their own. I want to tell you guys the truth. You're sure you're not just trying to use this? Complaints just never end, do they? I'm gonna talk like that. I won't want to tell you anymore. You might learn about what your talent is too.
Well.
Huh? Violet wasn't the only one I received from Monokuma. This is another one.
Yep.
The seal. Hopi's Academy School of Crest.
Perhaps.
Information about our stolen memories. Fortunately, we couldn't find any clues about that. Violet doesn't contain our information. Just Hajime's information. Doesn't contain our information, just Hajime's information.
Why?
Just mine? Isn't that weird? Why only Hajime's information? Or troubling that you would ask me that? Must say I was always interested that Hajime was the only one who could remember his talent. But that ends now, are you serious? Did we find out whether I was chosen by Hopi's Academy? As Chiaki said, Hajime's existence is special. Because you were. You're some reserve corps student from the reserve department.
Well.
Huh? On the primary department for main course students who possess ultimate talents. The reserve department is for reserve course students who enter the school through a basic entrance exam. Essentially, you're like a substitute or the second string. Even then, but just in name only. The reserve department pretty much only exists to increase Hopi's Academy's revenue stream. Reserve department? Substitute? Second string? Reserve revenue stream? What is he saying? Your realm, okay? The hydrate. I'm out of water? What the heck? Hold. We'll probably just get to the trial and save it. If I had to imagine just 1 minute. Okay. You need to possess an ultimate talent. Pay a rather costly entrance fee and tuition. The funds obtained from these exams, the Academy can focus on bolstering their researching talent. Simple to hope you can be raised.
Isn't that right?
And you're just a stepladder, but you shouldn't feel honored. Average talent, this human can be put in good use for those who are known to mankind. So, what the heck does that even mean? Something weren't determined enough? Do you admire hope? Are you willing to sacrifice your body and soul to attend this academy? Maybe you were just obsessed with Hope Beats Academy, like a fair goal for all I really just read.
Stop.
I don't like that. I want to become Hope. Is that what you're thinking? To stop it. Think carefully, the only humans worthy of becoming Hope possess amazing talents and strong wills. The moment you're born in this world, you either have that or you don't. It has nothing to do with the effort. It must be chosen by
you
Hope.
You don't even
Hope.
Know?
So why is it not even worth admiring? Or were you so blinded by your men? Admiration for Hope Peace Academy that you couldn't even see it. God. Nobody from the reserve force who had never had the talent being with. Nobody here forgets he was nobody, that's all. And I'm just. That's right, you were never an ultimate, you had no talent whatsoever. You had no talent. You're flat. Mr. Ordinary High School student. But sorry for you, and are you shocked to learn that you were the only
that's
one that had talent? Think about it positively. It looks like there's no more reason to doubt you. Now I know who you are, a normal, average, utterly unremarkable high school student. No way you could be associated with the Future Foundation. But if not Hajime, then who in the world could the traitor be? Survivor of the bravest kill in school life, Byakuya would have been the most likely candidate. But now that's probably impossible.
Hey,
hold it.
Are you listening? No need for you to lie. You need. There's no need.
What?
To listen to this.
Well.
Huh? It may be important to talk about who the traitor is, but we need to focus on Mekamara's murder first. We can't survive the class trial, everyone's going to die together anyway. In that case, would the traitor be among those killed as well?
Yep.
Something I truly wonder about.
Hey,
I'll stop for now. Through the final dead room and obtain these files, that means you must have gone to the Octagon, right? Curious about the ultimate weapon? Did you find out what it was? Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. Is there any real reason I should answer that? Huh? What the heck? I'm the one who cleared the room, and I'm free to divulge any clues I obtained there as I see fit, right? Trying to keep it a secret? Are you putting it aside with the killer again? I'm on the killer's side, but it hasn't changed since that business began. How many times must I repeat myself? I just want hope to shine even brighter. What you're saying doesn't make any sense at all. Tell us everybody, tell us about the ultimate weapon. I suppose I can tell you one little tidbit. Go to a place that seemed to be the Octagon, and I found many different weapons in there. Didn't find anything worthy of the name ultimate weapon.
Stop.
Well, that's possible. Coming from someone with no talent like yourself, that's truly offensive.
Oh.
What did you say? I understand, now is not the time for us to be fighting anyway. You won't tell us we got to do it ourselves, now shall we go back to investigating Mekamara's case. Better hurry, the
past
trial is going to start soon. You're right, I haven't even seen the crime scene. Also, the guy's strawberry house should be coming over
to
the side any moment now. While we're at it, I'll go on ahead.
Hey.
Hey, Hajime. It's okay, I already know you want me to focus on Mekamara's case right now too, right? True that I'm shocked, but now's not the time for me to feel like that. Can't afford to be the only one who's depressed. and to survive with everyone else and return home. That's what's the most important.
Yep.
Isn't that right? I'm gonna leave it here. That we should get moving then. Yeah, you're right. Should just forget about it for now. Where am I going? Where do you want to go, Jackie? Okay, back to the Mechamaru. Train from the depths of heck.
Yo,
Gundam.
Hey.
Sorry, we're late. So you know, it's all thanks to me. I'm the one who fixed the elevator.
Hey,
as I said,
hey.
Right? You listened to me and trying to stand out here. More importantly, Kazuchi, did you look into that matter I asked you about? The thing about the compass. I looked at it while I was coming here, but I think the compass would be broken.
Quiet.
Been asked for your opinion and tell me the results. Oh, well. Compass needle rotated at 180 degrees while we were riding the elevator. The needle rotated at 180 degrees. Just as I thought, huh?
No,
by that.
That's obvious.
Obviously, the elevator must likely rotate at 180 degrees.
Now
elevator then. Rotated? Should go investigate Nakamura's body. He was thumbing his nose as a snuggy toe began making his way to the towards the Great Tower. What's wrong with him? Doesn't he seem angry or something? Nagito, what do you know? How much do you know? Kazuchi's account has been added to the true bull section of your handbook. You can talk with everybody first. I made you wait. Title has come to destroy all murderous illusions. Time has come. Sorry.
Damn.
Come on, let's go over there. That's fine.
You serious?
Genkamaru, are you serious? Darn it, I didn't know who did this, but this is pretty flipped up. Now it's time to get sentimental. Come on, we need to hurry up and investigate. We already investigated everything we can here. Maybe we haven't installed something you should be able to investigate more thoroughly. And the Mikan's no longer here, but those we can perform an autopsy. Kazuchi said to be able to disassemble the body, right?
It cannot be!
Is that true? Are you going to disassemble Nakamura's body?
I won't forgive you!
Don't screw with me. Hasn't Coach Nakamura been through enough already? Been through enough? We need to perform this investigation so we can find out who the killer is. Perhaps you don't want to know, Akane? You don't care about what happened to Nakamura?
You stay quiet.
It's like using your brain and you really want to know who the killer is, so we're not interfering so much.
Jeez.
Come on, Kazuchi, what are you sitting there for? Darn it, fine, I just have to do it right. I know I said I wanted to see his inside, but not like this.
Well,
this is just too much. You guys feeling okay too? Now's not the time to be staring into space. There's something wrong with you, Nagito? Thought he was just treating me differently ever since he found out I had no talent, but seems like that's not entirely the case. Attitude towards everyone else is strange now too. But why? Don't do it?
Damn it!
So far, there's no way they can get sentimental all the time like this. Feel awful for Nakamura, but this is necessary if we're going to find out the truth behind the case. As he forces out of the voice with the clenched teeth, the chief faced Nakamura with his eyes full of determination and began stabbing his tool knife in Nakamura's body.
Huh?
Where'd he get a tool knife? Nagito gave it to me and said he had it ready before we even went to the Bennington Park. Nagito did that too. It's like Nagito has full control of the situation. Like the damage in his head is the reason? No. The reason Nagito died? I mean, it stopped functioning.
Hmm.
Where so is covered in huge dents, parts are dislocated. Maybe a gear shift broke? Well, for now, I tried disassembling Nakamura's chest. That should help us learn something, right? If that's the case, I need to look at Nakamura's body one more time. Apparently, Kazuchi has finished assembling Nakamura's body. I'll check it out one more time. Nakamura's chest panel is open. The clock inside is completely exposed. Hands on the clock, look like they're pointing towards 7:30. Like the clock's alarm set was for 7:30 a.m. Clock broke the moment the alarm started ringing at 7:30 a.m. Clock's alarm timer added to a bullet section of your handbook. 7:30 a.m., isn't that strange? We should have arrived at Gabe Tower just before 7 o'clock. I'm gonna come with Taiji. Clock malfunctioning. No, wait. Highly efficient radio clock. Radio clock. Have a clock that receives radio signals so that it can automatically update the time at the fixed interval. Simply put, it's extremely, extremely accurate clock. It's a clock that will never slow down, even designed that it cannot be adjusted. I'm the Time Lord. Even if it's an accurate clock, you didn't need to install inside your body. What are you saying? I don't need to wear a wristwatch ever again? Nothing more useful than this. So he was going on time. The clocks were changed to be 2 hours late. He was on time to the dojo. Thanks to the hamsters. That's the case. Watch the book clock should say it's 9:07:30 a.m. Radio clocks have been added to the tool section of your handbook. What's wrong with him? Crashing over Nekomaru's body and it almost seems like he's glaring at him.
You're the worst!
This is the worst, huh? Guys overlooked an important clue as where you're just the worst. No way I can leave this to you guys.
Well,
talking about? I was under a fragment of the pillar that tipped over.
You don't even know?
Screws came out of it. Wouldn't happen unless you applied a ton of force to it. Looks like there's scratches near the base of the doorknob. You think it's strange?
See?
If we examine the far back door of the Grape Tower, the doorknob is still intact, right? As you mentioned it, you're right.
Now then.
That's the case, where did this doorknob come from? It was not the door that leads to the stairway, strawberry hall, and only one other possibility. To be the door connected to the grape hall that we entered from, right?
Well,
makes sense to think about it like that. Let's try it out.
Don't know. Try it out.
We did a little bit of strawberry house, and we entered the strawberry tower from strawberry hall. Only one way we can see the other side of that door, right? Barring the door of the strawberry hall,
it's obvious, ribbon, right?
Just repair it. After all, we have the ultimate mechanic on our side. Any parts to repair the door to Strawberry Hall? The imperative is broken, but if we don't have enough parts, there's nothing much I can do about it.
Huh?
Plenty of parts right here.
See?
Huh? Like a Mario, I'm sure if you dig through his body, you can find parts you can use. Hold on. We should use parts from our dead friend. All recycling is much better alternative than disposing of the rest of this junk, right?
Hey.
Junk? Hey, well, Kazuchi, is it possible or impossible? Like I said, I could probably use this part to repair the button, but seriously, hold on. Even if you do repair the button, what's going to happen to the chain that lives on the door? Chain? The door that leads to the Strawberry Hall has a chain wrapped around it. Even if you fix the button, the Strawberry Hall side, the door won't open along with the chain is there. You don't need to worry about that at all, huh? Don't need to worry, what does that mean? We should go over to the Strawberry Hall so you can repair the door. Not finished. Going to come later too, right? Be really bothersome if you didn't. Someone out in the tower, the door won't open at all. You should at least make sure you're not pulling my leg. After tearlessly saying that, Nagito left the area.
Huh?
What happened to him? He's on the edge about something?
Damn right.
Goodness. Reminds me, Nagito asked Kazuchi to do something weird for him, right? Something to do with how the elevator spins 180 degrees.
Hey.
Whatever that could mean. Oh, the truth, Nagito asked me to do something weird too. I'm gonna investigate all the clocks inside both buildings. Clocks? It was said and checked up them all, but none of the clocks were the time messed up. When he asked me to do that in the first place, I don't get that dude at all. For now, why don't you head over to Strawberry Tower too? Along the doorknob matter, there are still many mysteries surrounding that we don't understand. Go to Strawberry Tower, we might be able to solve some mysteries, maybe.
Pathetic.
Let me guess what we have to do. Let's head over. You're right. What Nagato did about the said about the door opening? What's he going to do about the chain? It won't come off easily, so what does Nagato have a plan or something? I don't understand this at all. I am like mumbling now. We're gonna just get to the trial, and then we're gonna save it. So. Watching the elevator, I made my way to the strawberry house.
What's up?
Hey.
You're here? How'd the repairs go? Damage wasn't too bad once I got the parts, so I was able to fix it right away. On nerves saying there was when you used Nakamura's parts without my permission.
Now then.
And even so, now they're all here, why don't we hurry up and try it out? All we'll have you press the button, strawberry on the door. No, it'll open, you haven't done anything about the chain.
Hey!
I don't gotta see this, man. About to buy a chain, remember? If you didn't do anything about that, it doesn't even matter if you fixed the button, I'm just outside. Well, we'll never try it out. Not even worth trying out. Come this far, saying we should try it out, we should give it a shot. That'd be great. This door was open, thus not with the side chained up. With a feeling of resignation, I rent the button. I figure the room spins, but...
Hey!
Part of the open? Where did the chain go? The only thing that's strange. There's no other way to say it. This definitely looks weird.
Hey!
You know? Hey, doesn't this all look the same as when we got... when we were in the Grape Tower? Yeah, you're right. When we were inside Grape Tower, the Kamara's body was in front of the far back door. Which means his body should be in front of the door to the Strawberry Hall. When we enter from Strawberry Hall, his body should be in front of the door as we walk in. Why isn't it like that? Why isn't Nakamura's body in front of the door? The Great Hall.
Hey!
Is that the parts that I carefully arranged when I disabled the body I'll move to? Body isn't all into that mood, even that's ripped over a pillar of this pillar oil. Moves exactly the same way. Crime scene looks identical to how we saw when we entered the Great Hall. Everything that was at the crime scene inside Great Tower shifted to the opposite side. That's if it rotated 180 degrees, right? I can imagine that the floor would actually rotate 180 degrees, but is that really what it means? More than that, I feel like there's an even greater mystery here. This would be so great that it could drastically affect the outcome of the case. Might have to rethink this. Might have to fundamentally rethink how we've been approaching this case.
I see.
It disappeared, the strange feeling I felt when I went back and forth between the two towers. So I thought it was definitely the right choice to remember this. Was it your thought that we already knew about this mystery? You have a bad habit of relying on others when you don't understand.
See?
Let's try investigating first. We're in the far back of the picture of the grape on it. Maybe there's a clue in there. Clue on that door. The handle's gone? Yep. Where was the picture of the grape on it? Should be leading the grand, grape hall. Oh yeah. On the doorknobs is gone. Like the screws came out with it.
Now then.
Same as the knob that was on the floor. See the screws that came out with it, right? This doorknob next to the Nakamura's body came off the door of the Grape Hall. That's what it looks like. When it's a clue, are you talking about this? But why is it a clue? The broken doorknob has been updated to your handbook. You have the two bullet section to review it. You get even more confused? Don't worry, just one clue will change everything. All the mysteries will be solved as if everything were linked together if you can reach it. The guy did. What does that mean? Even if I ask him that, Nagato probably won't even give me an answer. Okay, what's the time to ask? I can go to bed.
It appears that it's time for the class trial! To tell you the truth, I'm tired. Extremely tired! I feel like spending the rest of my life hibernating already!
Just seven rooms, huh?
Man,
what I said to myself.
I know it's bad, but I'm so sleepy. I just want a ditch. Though I really don't feel like it, I'll show you my serious side when you come to the class trial. Even though it's impossible since it's so annoying, you can count on me to take this seriously.
Going to start another class trial.
Hey.
Are we supposed to get the trial ground? Can't do anything unless we get out of this building.
Hey.
Something happened? Let's hear something?
Hey.
Hear something? What do you hear this time? Cutting off Chalky, our surroundings started to shake and rumble. Suddenly appeared before us. Plans to go inside from here?
Right.
Seems that way. Wanna go? Oh, Nekomaru, I'll make sure I avenge you. Please be a little bit cautious, this is obviously a trap. It takes the scent of danger, even from my familiars are saying don't go inside. Interesting, if you heal me, you're welcome to try. I trust having a sword in my very heart. Now and then, we shall get moving as well. You're right. Annoying, but Miss Sonya's going.
Damn
it. I'm going. You're gonna go? So dang annoying. Doesn't matter if it's a trap or not. One by one, everyone went to Mount Gumarok. So there was only one left. Well, I'm about to take a step forward. We're the same. Same step ladders. Huh? Nagato was suddenly standing next to me with his eyes locked on the Mount Gumarok. Other than the small movements of his mouth, he was perfectly still. You and I are just step ladders. For everyone who still holds the title of Ultimate. I wouldn't believe that, didn't mind. Unlike you, I know my place.
Man.
What are you saying? Wise prepared to become a sacrifice at any time, and from that, true hope would be born. Always believed that the talent that survived would be true hope. If it wasn't, there was no hope amidst all this killing. Of course there is, and what kind of hope comes from killing people? Really? You're suggesting that sacrificing others for hope isn't a real hope? But you're wrong. Only natural and extremely obvious that strong hope
is that right?
After all, that's what it means to live, right? No way I'm going to accept that. Oh well, ultimately that's what I wanted to say to you anyway. There's this one novel I like. It's a peculiar mystery story. A novel? The story is told from the point of view of a high school girl involved in a serial killer mystery. And yet to the end, surprise, surprise, the girl was actually the killer. Of course, the story is written carefully so the reader doesn't learn the ending in the middle of the story. The protagonist is just a projection of the reader, and the projection turns out to be the killer. Which means the killer you were looking for the whole time is inside you all along. How do you feel about novels like that? What the heck are you trying to talking about? You're just jumping from one topic to another. Hey, comment on a book
no
I never even read.
At all.
Your moral answer, I should have expected that from a talentless reserve course like you. But you don't matter at all, so why do I care about you? You matter hope, I love hope. Some ways were similar, but maybe the difference is what's making me so emotional. Enough already. I don't have time to argue with you, let's go, everyone's waiting. Everyone, huh? You still believe you're just like everyone else. Reserve course students are so full of themselves. Nagato's chilling laugh continued as he disappeared into the Mount Gumarok. Calm down, that's where I needed to calm down. Travel deep breaths, and once my nerves had settled, up to the Mount Gumarok. Well, the bitter shook violently as it descended at an ever increasing speed.
Hey!
We're in room elevator, and that's straight out of Six's bed. Reminds me how efficient the elevator in the front house was. That's probably true. The elevator continued to shake, and ascended deeper and deeper. Suddenly, it stopped like it always does. And the door opened.
Well now!
I understand your desire to applaud this wonderfully vulgar trial ground. It's always awesome to discuss useless things, so let's just get on with it already. So sad, my chest hurts, forcing everyone to do this. So sad.
Come on now.
Don't be talking about permission and drive out of my catchphrase.
I'm really
angry. Otherwise, I'll roll the dice, and based on the result, I'll give you a sex change operation that many times.
Now
then.
Extreme
punishment. Now then, let's get on with this once again. Get a move on, boys and girls. So it begins. I hope this would never happen again, and now it's happening for a fourth time. Curtain to the fourth class trial was about to open. Like Mario Nidai, the ultimate team manager. More passionate, more daring, more honest than anyone I've ever met. Really, he was a man. More man than any of us. Sacrificed his body to protect Akane, and his appearance changed drastically because of that. Still tried to live earnestly. Just when I finally got used to his new form. Like Mario's killer. They're right there. Killing someone because it's the only way to survive with no excuse. Won't just be excuse. I won't forgive any of this. Person who betrayed Akamaru, who betrayed their friends, never ever forgive them. And so, life-threatening trial that beloved with hope and despair has begun. I'll give him backup just in case. Sure, just put him on. Can't, okay. Alright, well, I'm gonna do a slash marker or cut, and then I'm out of here. Not cut, I'm gonna end it.